Hello dear students, today again we are talking on the new numerical question on cost sheet. As we have already seen the different numerical questions, but today in this question instead of profit there is a loss. So let's talk about the question. The question is, prepare a cost sheet from the following information of Relic India Limited for the year ending 31st March. This question I have taken from the success publication book. So if you want to refer this question, you can also refer the book so that you will get the question. So in this question, purchase of raw material is given. As you know, purchase of raw material is related with the direct material. So therefore, this item will belongs to direct material. Now the next is freight paid on raw material purchases. So as you know, freight is related with carrying on the goods from the manufacturer to the place of production. So that is the reason freight will be again added to the direct material. Next is productive wages. Productive wages are also called as direct wages. So therefore this item will comes under the direct wages, or you can say direct labor. Unproductive wages, this will be forming a part of your factory overheads. Now productive wages outstanding, again they are related with the direct wages, so it will be added in the direct wages. Next is royalties on production. So royalty becomes an direct expenses, so therefore this will be coming under the heading direct expenses. Now fuel and power. Fuel and power is mostly required in the factory, therefore it will be forming part of your factory overheads. Factory rent, again it is related with the factory. Insurance of machinery, as machineries are used in the factory, again it will be forming a part of your factory overheads. Next is loading and unloading charges on purchase of raw material. As this is related with the purchase of raw material, it will be forming part of your direct material. Next is depreciation on machinery. Again, machineries are used in the factory, it will be again related with the factory overheads. Now lighting. Here specifically lighting overheads regarding factory, that will be constituting form of factory overheads, and related with the office, it will be coming under the office overheads. Now factory cleaning. Factory cleaning is related with the factory overheads. Advertising, they are related with the selling and distribution overheads. Now carriage outward. Carriage outward means when the goods are going out from the organization, so therefore they are related with the selling overheads. Income tax, as this is non-cost item, so it will not be forming a part of cost sheet. Factory telephone, this is again related with the factory overheads. Plant repairs and maintenance, this is related with your factory overhead because plants are used in factory. Office computer depreciation, computer is used in office, so therefore it will be office overheads. Office stationery, again it is related with the office overheads. Traveling expenses of the salesman, so salesman's traveling expenses coming under the selling overheads, and office staff traveling expenses will be forming part of your office overheads. Now donations, again this is non-cost sheet item, so therefore it will not be forming part of your cost sheet. Salaries of sales staff, so as it is related with sales staff, it will be forming part of selling overheads. Marketing research expenses, most of the times you need to do the research regarding marketing activity, whether your product is being acceptable by the consumers or not. So this is again becoming part of your selling overheads. Now bank charges and interest, again this item is financial in nature, so therefore it will not be forming part of your cost sheet. Expenses on office car, it will be forming part of your office overheads. And office manager salary, again it is related with the office overheads. And bad debts, they are related with your selling overheads. And finally sales, sales will be written in the sales final. Now we will post this problem into the cost sheet form. As you can see, first of all, raw material purchase is 1,55,000. In this raw material, loading and unloading charges on purchase of raw material at 35,000 has been added. Next is purchase of raw material of rupees 4,000 is being added. So total 1,62,500. In this raw material purchase, we will add the direct labor. So in this question, the productive wages paid and productive wages outstanding, they both are forming part of your direct wages. So therefore, 1,62,500 plus 75,000 plus 7,000 is equal to 2,44,500. Now third element of cost, that is direct expenses. So here, royalties on production, they are related with the direct expenses. Hence, 1,62,500 plus 75,000 plus 7,000 plus 18,000 royalties on production, total 2,62,000 will be your prime cost. Now in the prime cost, we add factory overheads. Now under the factory overhead, all the indirect expenses, that is material, labor and expenses which are used in factory, that will be forming your factory overhead. Under that, unproductive wages, 22,000 rupees has been taken. Second is fuel and power of rupees 4,500. Factory rent of rupees 6,300. Insurance of machinery 1,700. Depreciation on machinery. See, machineries are used in factory, so therefore it has taken under the factory overhead. Factory cleaning expenses 400. Factory telephone expenses 890. Plant repair and maintenance rupees 2,500. And lighting of the factory 700 has been taken. So total factory overhead is 47,290. So in the 2,62,500, if we add 47,290, we will get here the factory cost or you can say work cost is equal to rupees 3,09,790. Now after the factory cost, we have to add the office overhead. In the office overhead, lighting of the office 300, office computer depreciation 12,000, office stationery of rupees 2,100, traveling expenses of office staff, so it is specifically mentioned office staff is traveling for office purpose, so 1,800 has been added, expenses on office cars of rupees 3,500 is being added, and finally office manager salary of rupees 5,400 has been added. So the total office overhead is 25,100. So 3,09,790 plus 25,100, total cost of goods, so cost of production. Is equal to 3,34,890. Now after that, we have to add the selling and distribution overhead. Under the heading selling and distribution overhead, advertising rupees 3,700, carriage outward rupees 1,300, traveling expenses of salesman rupees 3,500, salaries of sales staff rupees 7,000, and marketing research expenses of rupees 1,400. And last, bank debt rupees 700. So total of these selling and distribution overhead is rupees 17,600. So in the cost of goods sold, if you add all these 17,600, so you will get the total cost of rupees 3,52,490. As you know, our sales is rupees 3,50,000. So our total cost is more than the sales. So therefore, there is a loss of rupees 2,490. If you have any of the question regarding this particular video, you can comment in the Google Classroom. And if you like the video, please subscribe my channel, share. Thank you.